you have one of these toilets and you're looking at this video and you go, oh, that's mine. That's the one. I got the double flush one and it looks exactly like that. This is the one you want. A little bit's come off as well. And now I can sort of hold these two, put my fingers here and push like this downwards. And now to grip it. And then I'm going to pull out and peel it off. And then I fit it through like this. You're trying to fix the toilet because it's leaking. And you just know there's a little washer in there that you have to replace, but you don't know how. You take off the lid, you look at your thing and you go, oh, it's this brand. So you go out and you buy a brand that you think belongs to your toilet and you come home and you don't really know whether it's correct or not. Well, this video is going to show you a few tips and mistakes that I've made so that you can go through and change this washer. Now have a look over here. Here are some mistakes that I've made. I looked at my toilet and it said Fowler, right? And so I went out there and I bought a Fowler brand washer. And when I took it home, you can see that I've hacked this up because I tried to make it fit and I couldn't. And this one just won't even stretch because it's for the wrong one completely. Turns out I don't even have a Fowler cistern pump thing, right? It's Caroma. I had to go out and buy Caroma. Now, if you have one of these toilets and you're looking at this one and you're looking at this video and you go, oh, that's mine. That's the one. I got the double flush one and it looks exactly like that. This is the one you want. I just fixed downstairs toilet and it fits perfectly and it stops leaking. Now, the reason why it leaks, this thing will go drip, 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 and it'll drive you insane. And also it will run all this water out, is because that washer is wearing thin and the water is leaking out. And you'll know, if you look at the toilet, it will drip. It'll drip down there. And right now it's actually dripping. And it's just, you can see like, but it's not dripping, but it's slowly losing your water, which means as it replaces it, you're just constantly turning the tap on and wasting money. So to remove this one, it's a little bit tricky because if you have never pulled this out, it's quite hard to pull it out. It's stuck because of, you know, over plastic over time. You have to push this two and these two. These are the clips that are holding it. So we first want to turn off the mains down here. Turn it off. Now no water is going to come out. And then I like to like flush it all. And then that way I don't have like all the water here holding it all back. I put my fingers here. Just here, just to support this, because I'm constantly lifting it up. And then I'm going to push these two clips forward. And as I push them forward, I'm sort of like jiggling. See, the little bit has come out. So if a little bit's come out, I'm going to push it out with this. Now that this has sort of come out, I'm going to open these two clips. I'm putting my fingers here and I'm putting my hand here to pull this clip. And if that's come off a tiny little bit like that, just then I'm going to work on this side. And now that I can sort of feel that tiny little bit's come off as well. And now I can sort of hold these two, put my fingers here and push like this downwards. And now this whole unit is going to come off and it hangs like this. This thing hangs. Try not to move this too much. I'm just gonna pour this water out. Now, I'm gonna turn this upside down so we can see, purely because of just showing. But normally I would work this over the sink. Now, as you can see, This rubber is gone. It's disgusting. It's like, and that's why it's leaking. To take this out, I'm gonna use a cloth because it's slippery and it's disgusting. I'm gonna lift up this tiny bit just underneath here, like that. And then I'm just gonna use a towel to grip it. And then I'm gonna pull out and peel it off. So you can see like all that gunk and grossness is on my hands now. Just look down there. You'll notice that, see all that plastic and debris, and that's giving little pockets for the water to flow in. So what you want to do is grab a cloth or a towel and clean that up. We're going to get some toilet paper. Probably good to use a towel so it don't leave bits and pieces, but if you're careful, you can just wipe it clean. I'll just show you roughly what I'll do, and then I'll clean the rest myself. Be careful of this. You don't want to use anything harsh to damage it, because if you do, it won't seal. So don't scrub it. See, look at that. Is that all that when the rubber sits on it, it's not gonna work. Now it's nice and clean. You can see that the ring has no debris on it and is smooth. If you run your hand around it, it should be completely smooth. I'm just gonna clean off some of these bits because you don't want gunk and rubber, leftover rubber on your ring. You see little bits of rubber still coming off. Okay, pretty clean now. I just make a little thing and clean off any extra bits of rubber. Like this, look at that. See? Tiny little rubber like that, that's sticking on the inside, is gonna cause a leak. And that's all it takes. Tiny, tiny little hole. I'm gonna put in the new washer. You gotta make sure you find the exact same one because it makes a huge difference. Even if you, this is the old one. Even if you, or it's one of the old ones. If you put it like that and you go, oh, it doesn't really fit. It doesn't really matter as long as like the inside fits, because it has to go all the way in. If it's too thick and it does go all the way in, it will leak no matter how tight you think you got it. Now, this is tricky to put on and fit properly. So if you put a little bit of soap, which by the way, is not my idea. This is all the stuff that I've read and watched videos on the internet. It does actually help. So I like to do this. I put my two fingers here and then I fit it through like this. Now don't use your fingers to do that. Just this thing here, you can turn it. And when you turn it, it will sort of help position the line on the inside. If it's out by a little, I use my towel and I just jiggle it to make it even. Don't use your fingernails because you'll damage the washer. And also make sure this isn't sitting outside, otherwise it will not. Then you have a look here. I don't know if you can see this position here. See how this ring is all touching, but this isn't? See? Right there.
So if you turn this a bit back and forth, it'll try to readjust itself. If it doesn't, like in this case, it's not doing it, then you'll just have to pull it out a little bit and then readjust it. Because if that's not touching the edge ring, I mean the inside, then it's not gonna work. So just reposition it to keep it within this circle. It's a bit better now. Now the front is this way. We're going to drop it down here. Not literally drop. And also make sure like all this is still in place before you put it in. If you've somehow dislodged it, hook it back. The way I do this one is I first put this side in and I push this tab in and this one in. See, push this tab into this one in, and then I just let it sit a very small amount in there so it's positioned there. And then I'm gonna work on this one, and this one I'll try and lift this up and I make sure that's sitting there as well. See, both these are now sitting together at the bottom. Both this and this is now just sitting there. And so when you push it in now, these clips should go snap. So if I push that in, and then I push this side in, all this should be flush now. Make sure it's flush. Because the, even if you're off by a bit, this thing will be off as well. Turn the water back on. If there was water, there would be water all over my finger right now. So now we know it's working. Also, once it's finished, it might do a few drips, so don't be hasty and go, oh no, it's not working. Like, it will still drip a bit and then it will stop. See, look, it's not dripping. And now I'm gonna do a flush. And it'll fill itself up. The tank will run a little bit. The rest of the residue water will run down a tiny bit, but it will not have like a constant stream. You'll be able to see it in the water that this is still. If the water is running, then you know you've got a problem. And also, you can tell when this goes drip, 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 like constantly. Like if you want to do a test, you can turn off the main water and just watch for an hour or two. Or not watch, wait. And the and the water will be all gone if it's leaking. So then you know, oh crap, I have to refit the washer. But otherwise, if you don't hear the dripping, you don't feel the dripping, you're not gonna get a dripping. And that's how you change this toilet. Hopefully, it helps all of the people out there who's got an old toilet like me. This is about 16 years old, this Caroma Duo Flow thing. And this is the one you want. So if you skipped all the way to the end, this is the one you want. You wanna get this from Bunnings, $2 something for one. And this one is $9 something for a 10 pack. So I figure I'll just get a 10 pack just in case I screw it up, and also in for the future. And to finish it off, put the lid back on. and move on to your next toilet.